What's going on, everybody? The Original Mako back with some more Gunfire Reborn content. And first of all, what are you doing? You're not subscribed to the channel? 88% of the people, about-ish, last month, who watched the videos were not subscribed. Hit that subscribe button now. There's going to be so much content coming out to you guys, not only Gunfire Reborn, but all sorts of other games. I mean, Gunfire Reborn's going to have their roadmap coming out. There's some Godfall stuff I still want to do. There's other games coming out. There's other games that hopefully I'll be able to actually stream soon that I want to make content on. So there's a lot of stuff waiting for you guys. If you just hit that subscribe button, hit the bell, turn on notifications so you can be up to date on all of your favorite content needs from your favorite content creator, which is obviously no doubt me. Anyways, today I'm going to be talking about the daily challenges. Now, obviously these were implemented a while ago, but I was on a little hiatus, when these were introduced. So I never had a chance to cover it right away and give my thoughts. But after having played some daily challenges and seen kind of how it goes through and how it works, I decided I was going to go ahead and weigh in. And I'm going to talk about some stuff first, and then I'm going to talk over some gameplay of a daily challenge that's going to go on in the background. At that aside, let's just go ahead and start talking about some of this stuff. And first of all, so the way they do it is they have a main thing here, obviously. Like, this is never changes. So whenever there's an unavoidable confrontation daily challenge, you always start with Flesh and Bones and Paranormality. Greatly decrease enemies' health, including armor and shield. No bun for the game, and heroes get one extra resurrection. I am going to actually just go ahead and do this. So that stuff never changed. These special effects are typically very similar, but there are occasional slight differences that can happen with these special effects. But most of the time, it's pretty standard what you're going to see for the daily challenges. I'm not sure if there is an exact number. I'm sure somebody has one, but this is the fourth one I've seen. So I don't think there are very many in the game. Now, I don't know how many there are. I don't know if there's even enough for a whole week to be different. But first, I'll start with that. Obviously, there needs to be more daily challenges. Now, I know this was a feature that just got into the game, right? So, like, beggars can't be choosers. But I still think even on its first release, there has to be more challenges, at least enough to cover a week or so, probably even longer, without having repeats, because constantly having repeat challenges is frustrating and annoying. And it's like, you know, I just did this one 3 times last week. I don't want to be playing it again this next week. So more challenges, but obviously that's going to come as the game gets later into its development phase. The two other things I would say that I would really want to change are these special effects. They can slightly vary, but I think these need to be like randomly generated. Like, there's like 3 or 4 different things that could have like 2 good things, 2 bad things or something that are just random out of a huge list of things that could happen. So like, if this is a special effect, you could get this in a different daily challenge. You get this exact one, or you could get this exact one in a different challenge. Like, things that can be used in multiple different challenges. So once again, it just brings more variety to each challenge. So even if you are redoing a challenge, it's like, oh, I have 4 completely different special effects this time. So it makes it a completely different game. That's the whole point of, you know, roguelike games, is that every single run is completely different. And with these daily challenges, it seems like most of the time, if you're doing the run, the same daily challenge, it's basically the same run almost every single time. I do like how it's only 1 stage, though, and that stage does change even if it's the same daily challenge. So that is makes it a little bit different. And obviously not having to do the whole game kind of makes sense for a daily challenge. So I like that. That's a pretty good thing about it. But they just need more variety, more ways to make each run for the daily challenge feel different. Because once you do it once, there's really not a lot of motivation to do it again. But I like all that, but I like the fact that, you know, the different stages and stuff. So I think those two are 2 pretty big things that need to be changed. And also, the next big one, I would have to say, and the only other real gripe that I have, other than the, you know, special effects needing to be different, and the fact that there's not really enough challenges right now, is I think, and this is something that I wouldn't expect with the first implementation of daily challenges, but there needs to be some sort of scoring system that's not just damage. Like, there needs to be a, enemies need to have a certain amount of points, or you know, there needs to be time bonuses. There needs to be some way to quantify the run. Now, there's not that way for normal runs right now, but once again, normal runs, every single run's different in its own way. With daily challenges, if you're doing the same daily challenge, there needs to be a reason to replay a daily challenge over again. Like, let's say I do this unavoidable confrontation one, or the run that's going on in the background, the headshot run. Let's say I'm doing that. Once I'm done with it, I don't really want to play it again because it's just going to be the same thing over and over. But if I have a score at the end and I'm like, oh, or I see that I'm a certain place on the leaderboard with a score, I'm like, okay, I can do better than that. I can get a higher score. It gives you a reason to go back in and try. Like, there's definitely a way to do it, and there's space for it. But once again, that's something that I wouldn't expect in the first, you know, release of daily challenges. That's something I'd like to see implemented in the future. Because, and if they add all that stuff, having, there'd be infinite, there'd be multiple reasons to keep replaying the same challenges, daily challenges, over and over again on the same day. And if they come back up in rotation like a week or two later, there's tons of reasons to play it again that time too. So leaderboards would be something I'd really like to see. It's always fun to have some sort of, you know, quantitative way to look at the run that you just did and kind of see, oh, I can get better than that, or oh, that was really good, I want to kind of show this off and stuff like that. It's kind of like speedruns, you know, you have a time, and there's time you're always trying to beat, there's always goals for yourself, that was a good run, that was a bad run, there's ways to quantify it. So having that with daily challenges would be really nice. I know a lot of other games do it. Risk of Rain, last time I played Risk of Rain, it was broken. I'm sure they fixed it by now. But have, like, the time bonus, how fast you do it, be a part of it. Have the amount of scrolls that you have at the end be a part of it. So that way it doesn't, you know, you don't just want to go for time. You kind of want to go into the vaults to maybe try to get scrolls if it's a fast one, or what have you. Like, there's just a lot of really cool things you could do with that. So I think there's a way to make them more exciting, more replayable, and kind of take the whole heart of a roguelike experience and put it into the daily challenges. Because as of right now, they're just not replayable enough. If I see one that I've already played, I don't want to play it again. If I play one that I haven't played, I only play it once, assuming I complete it, and then I don't really want to play it again. So it's like, just make it more replayable. But overall, I do like that there is something there. There's like a baseline for it, and it's not a terrible base. I mean, obviously they have good ideas for challenges. The challenges have been decent so far. I just think the special effects could be a little bit more randomized. There could be a little bit more, and there could be a way to quantify it. So hopefully, you know, stuff like that will come with future updates. And frankly, I mean, we might see it in the roadmap that's supposed to come out in December. Should be in the next couple weeks. So hope maybe we'll see something about it there. I am excited for that roadmap. Like I said, be sure, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. You stay up to date on all the content. And also, check out the links in the description as well. Twitch.tv/TheOriginalMako. I'm actually doing a test this week where I'm actually going to be live at 11 a.m. Eastern instead of 8 p.m. Eastern almost every day. And I'm just testing to see, because morning stream would work better for me, so I'm just seeing what the viewership's like and stuff like that. So if you can make it to an 11 a.m. stream, hop on in, say hi. Don't say hi, just sit there and watch me want to break my face, because the nightmare mode, no ascension, no scroll challenge is extremely difficult. And my Discord's in the description as well if you want to hang out and talk to some really cool people there. So thank you all for watching. I'm going to go ahead and let the rest of this run in the background play out. Enjoy it. My commentary might pop up in a really weird place. Who knows what I'm talking about right now in the run, but enjoy the rest of this run. Thank you all for watching. I really appreciate it, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Corrosive ball? Oh, it's a wave room with this challenge? Oh. Kind of makes me want to throw up. Stay away. Away, I say. Alright, worm, where are you gonna be? Nice. Yeah, I think because of the way it reads, bosses should be included in that. But also, if you don't crit the boss, they restore health. That's my guess. I'm sure we'll find out when we do the final boss. Because eventually if we crit... Oh! Wait, there's two peddlers in here? Wait, I don't think I've ever seen this room spawn with two peddlers. It's usually either just a peddler, just a craftsman, or a peddler and a craftsman, but not a double peddler. Oh my god. Holy. Hey, what's up, Zeta? How you doing today? Oh no. Oh. Well, that was pooched. Come on. No. Okay. We got it. Oh, give me that. Run. Yeah, sure, we'll take Elemental Convergence. I mean, I'll look at these, but I'm going to keep it $150. This thing's hitting like a truck for this challenge. No. It's pretty good, but no. We'll take that, we'll take that, we'll do that. Oh, we'll do that again, we'll get some ammo. Look at this. This is a nice pick-me-up after that last No Scroll, No Ascension run. Oh. Wait, everybody's gonna turn into a worm. Oh, no. Oh, I got... Oh, we gotta be so careful. Oh, my... Wait, what the? Where did you come from? Oh! Okay, this area has completely flipped the script here. This is a lot more difficult. Did you die? Okay, that worm did die. No, 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 no. Stop, 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 stop. Whew. Oh. Okay. I think we're okay. Barely, but we're okay. Are you? Okay. Oh. What is that? I can't tell. It doesn't matter. Peddler. Holy magazine capacity, Batman. It's not a bad illusion. Actually, we'll take this illusion just in case it'll be better for the boss. But once again, I kind of really like what we're rocking with this bad boy. Like, this thing's hitting like a truck. Another peddler. How many goddamn peddlers are in this place? Oh. Okay. Well, chalk the illusion. Give me a Scorching Rounds that has that on it. I still think we're probably going to end up using the other thing more, but... Oh, wait. Oh, hold on. I'm not going to use that mainly because just the rate of fire is so garbage. Oh, finessed. See, kids, that's how you strafe. Oh, I need to... Oh, God, all my... Oh, hold on a second. Okay. I can see that well enough. Ow. All right, yes, please, max this out. Oh, it's light work. Oh, yeah. Yeah, give me coin shot. Doing almost 20k damage. That's not shabby. What the? You're gonna tell me... Okay, I was gonna say, you must not have a head or something. Okay, alright. I'm being actually pranked now. We just finessed his weak spot. Okay, let's see how this goes with the boss. Whatever. It's not a big deal. I should have whatever. Oh, right. This thing's plus 11. We should? If the boss can die instantly from a crit and can get healed from not crits, which I think would make sense, this shouldn't take very long. Okay, it's not gonna take very long either way. Holy damage. Oh. So if I... Oh, okay, so non-crit shots do heal him. Good to know. Here you go, buddy. I'll top you off. Because now you're... Oh, he went back into this form, though. Actually, couldn't... I'm trying to think. Couldn't you theoretically farm damage by getting the boss low, healing him, getting him low, healing him, getting him low, healing him? Couldn't you just repeat that over and over and just farm? And just get a stupid amount of damage dealt? Maybe. I don't know. I might have to try it.